Welcome to the Microsoft Dynamics CRM 2013 Application and User Interface. The talk today will be on the new features within CRM 2013, but also I'm going to compare them to the previous version in CRM 2011. My name is Kevin Tunstall and I'm a senior engineer within the CRM team in the UK. The agenda today, short session, really is just an overview with the learning objectives, which include the reimaged user interface, the new forms, and the navigation bar within CRM 2013. Now first, we'll talk about the reimaged UI that we've done in CRM 2013, and I will go through a demo later on in this presentation to get you a good feel of really the difference between the two models. So really, what the four things we focus on here, we've done the simplicity, the usability, the modernness of it, and the speed and fast of it. It's simple because it focuses on the essential functions with a clear, consistent purpose that really matches the user intention. It's usable because it measures usability, and we've incorporated feedback as well from CRM 2011 into the designs of CRM 2013. It's modern because you'll be able to tell we use the appropriate web interpretation of Windows 8 user interface to create this kind of delightful feel and smoothness into it, and it really does interact well with the Windows 8 experience. And it's fast because it designs and it delivers that performance that we do require. Now if we talk about the forms first, bring these up here. Now we all know that also in Microsoft Dynamics CRM December 2012 update, there were three form modes introduced. That was the classic, the read optimize, and the process flow based under the user interface for, say, contact, opportunity, lead, and accounts for those entities there. With CRM 2013, the presentation of most forms have been updated, and the extensibility gaps, for example, in the December 2012 service updates 2011, have been filled within the new capabilities, and these have now been added. So if we compare there between the top and the bottom, you can see the new user interface there on how much has changed compared to the classic there, and then what's left over. Now talking to forms itself just like a moment ago, there's been several out-of-the-box entities as well as the custom entities, and they've been updated to provide an improved user experience overall. And these entities are the ones which are the most commonly used by people who use the application to do their work, especially things like sales and marketing activities, everyday stuff really. There are other entities which were not updated, but these are kind of less frequently used, really from like managing side of things, for the service side, for the settings, you know, certain aspects and forms that won't be used to the everyday user within the system. And this slide here shows you about that. The next slide, or P here, so you can see quite a few boxes. There's 30 refresh entities. I won't go through them all here. You can have a quick look at them here between sales, marketing, service, and you see the configuration. You can see, for example, at the bottom there, the security roles and profiles, the document management, the goals performance management. These haven't been refreshed. So the refreshed ones are in the blue, as you can see on the Legion key on the right-hand side there. So all the important ones that really is what the everyday user will use, they have been absolutely refreshed in CRM 2013. And here's an example, really, the first look at the reimaged user interface. Just open up in a lead here, for example, Adam Carter in our test system here. And you can see there that it brings in Bing Maps on the bottom left-hand side and has all the information about it, with the website, with the address, with the phone number, and everything else. And obviously, the more activities, any Yammer feeds in here as well, will all be brought in. So that's your first example of how the user interface now looks in CRM 2013. And for those who are familiar with obviously CRM 2011 and CRM 4, you can see the real difference in there in the quality and how it feels and looks, which again I'll go through shortly within the demo. Now there's three main CRM application views. You have the first one here, which is the dashboard. Now we all familiar with the dashboard. It has the overview, it's kind of the mastery of the whole system. As you can see here, this is how Sue Walker's demo on this one here in AdventureWorks would look like. The next one would be the grid. It's the understanding of the kind of discrete collection of objects. It has it all in there. And then the form itself. And the form has the complete understanding of a single object. So for here, just showing the example for this one here, for the BI software implementation, with all the summary of the content information all below, and the facts and figures. Now, a word you might sign hear already is site flattening. You might ask yourself, well, what actually is site flattening? Well, it's an attempt to eliminate continuous window contextual switches that a user experiences through the course of using CRM web application. It's quite difficult to manage, and there are issues sometimes with performance that can arise. The focus in CRM 2013 with this release has been to reduce the number of clicks required to accomplish some specific actions, and really to optimize usage of the pop-up dialogues and windows with this. And what I'll do now is I will switch to the demo. What I'll show you first in here. Here is CRM 2013, and we can see it's clearly here now. And we're here at the dashboard. You'll see at the top here, and I've just put my cursor over the top, an automatic drop box comes down. We have sales, service, marketing settings, and the help section. We have obviously the icon for the home. Wherever you are, you click on that home button there, it will take you back to your dashboards of which you set up for home. And at the moment, I'm in sales. So I will click on sales, just like we are here. And you'll see here that the next one along is all in sales here. And you've got my work. If you've got different dashboards here, it will be underneath here. For example, my recently viewed dashboards are the sales and the marketing social one. You've got the watch new, stuff like the Yammer feed and what's coming through to the company. You have the activities, accounts, and so on. And what you can do here, if you go to mouse with a rollerball or the roller coaster wheel, you obviously won't be able to see myself doing this, but if I'm scrolling through now with my mouse using the rollerball, it's really, really smooth, really nice movements. You don't have to keep dragging your mouse across to the left and right. Again, just like the Windows 8 experience as well, obviously with a touch screen, you can use the touch screen for that, or with a mouse, you just do exactly what I'm doing now, and you'd flow through to whichever one you want to come to. So you can see here, this is the sub menu for sales. So if I say, oh, let's have a look at accounts here, you click on accounts, and underneath again, recently viewed. This is the same for all of them. If I had recently viewed contacts and leads, so on. So let's open up the demo for the Alpine Ski. And this account will open up now. Obviously, there's a demo, not much information here, but you can see here it starts pulling through the phone number, the contacts, and you can see the difference here in the form and how slick it is. And then obviously the Bing Maps loading up there in the bottom left hand side. Once it pinpoints a position for that address, the map there at the bottom left will load up. And you can see in the middle here the activities that would come through for this account as well. So it's a lot more professional kind of look, a lot more slick look, a lot faster looked than it was in CRM 2011. Also on here I say, this is exactly where we are now, Alpine. Now what we couldn't do before, as I was introduction before, about kind of site flattening, we can go backwards, just like you normally would in a browser. You'd hit the back button up here, and we'll go back to the page we were. And you couldn't do that before you had all the dialog boxes opening up. And as I said, it does cause performance issues, and you can have, you know, 10, 15, 20 windows open at the same time, and the user might get lost in kind of where they are. So it's all within this window now, makes it a lot easier. There still will be some pop-up windows needed become, but as a general rule of thumb here, the user will go through the dashboards, go through where they would like to be, into the contacts, and again, if you need to go back, you press the back button. So this is really how the new user interface looks. And if I was to go into here, for example, and let's say have a look at the settings section, you'd think, ah, that's very, very similar. This is still the same. He hasn't changed the logos. You've still got those nice colourful logos and the icons for it. For example, we're in business management here. Again, it's where it is. You're under settings. So you choose here, you might want to go down to administration. So we click on administration. Again, very, very similar to CRM 2011. As I said before, about 5 or so minutes ago, this bit really hasn't changed. This is kind of the stuff behind the scenes only the system administrators will have a look at. And this kind of menu for CRM 2013 still has the same look and feel to it. What you might see here at the top here is the create button. Wherever you are in CRM 2013 in your browser, you click on that create button and you have this really, really nice drop down, and you can create it at any point. It's a really, really quick, easy action to do. And we'll go from the left here, you can see the create new activities. You've got tasks, phone calls, emails, appointments in the calendar. And again, you can see all the rest here, case, contacts, etc. And obviously this is customizable as well. What you'll probably notice is the colors. Different colors there, red, orange, blue, and gray, and so on. I'll touch this later on in a slide and talk about what these colors might mean to you and what it means for CRM 2013. So you can see here, we'll hit the home button and go back to the home page, which will probably bring up the sales dashboard. And we'll come back to here again. So it's very slick, very professional looking. And if I just show you, for example, how it was, this here is CRM 2011. again the dashboard here, and you see the left hand side we have activities, we have the all listed in here. Again, this is all the sample data brought in via my account. We have all the sample accounts in here, and I would click on an account, and you see that doesn't happen in CRM 2013, all within the same window, and it really does affect the performance, and it's much, much better. If I was to go in here and open up another account and another account, you can see the windows increase at the bottom. Well, you can imagine if you've got a sales consultant who's on the phone, and you've got, say, you know, 8 or 9 different accounts information all open different windows, whereas 2013 it's all within one. It's a lot smoother. And again, just like I showed before, the settings very, very similar. It's all the same. But we go back to the workplace, and you can see here between marketing, it's all changed. You can see all the ribbon between that one there and 2013, all very, very different and really slick design. So really, from that quick little overview really between the differences here, this is the difference I put together. In CRM 2011, as I said, you have the left navigation, and it's always been on the left side of the page with different areas, modules and navigation links. In the new navigation model in CRM 2013, the navigation is now at the top with the items displayed in tile format, just like I was saying about the Windows 8 design for it. And to navigate, you click on the tiles and it will take you to the entity grid as an in-page experience rather than a pop-up window that I've said a few times already. So what are the key changes we've done in CRM 2013 for the kind of the in-page experience? Well, the workplace area is removed. The dashboards, activities and reports available in every module. The pop-out windows from the in-page experience, and the addressable URL changes, which we'll discuss in another talk later down the line as well, which makes it a lot easier to go to a specific URL. It's a much shorter, specific address for the URL in CRM 2013 compared to CRM 2011. And with the site navigation part of the browser history as well, like I said, with the back button, makes a lot user a better user experience as well for the user. And really, the concept of the workplace in CRM 2011 is being removed in CRM 2013. It's based on your security role. You can now view specific modules and all the items previously situated in your workspace area, and it will move you to an existing module like sales. Dashboards, activities and reports, as I said, will be available in every module. The mouse scroll wheel will also work with the navigation bar like I showed you in the demo, and it does save some time while navigating through. And the save and close button from the refresh forms has been eliminated. So pressing the back on the keyboard or on the browser takes you back to the previous page you were in. And pressing the browser forward, as I said, similarly takes you to the next view. And this is the navigation bar that we showed a moment ago. So it's now at the top of the screen rather than the traditional left-hand side that we're used to in CRM 4 and CRM 2011, and it collapses once you select an area. And in the new navigation, you can use a module switcher to select a module or area, and the next level displays by selecting a sub-area within that area. And then the third level of the navigation tree displays is the title for the entity record when opening a specific record. So you can see there the comparison between the CRM 2011 and now the CRM 2013 like we showed in the demo. And so clicking, hovering on product icon or the chevron next to it, it displays all the areas specified in the sitemap. You select an area, it will take you to the first sub-area in the sitemap underneath the area, which is dashboards by default. The navigation bar collapses by default, and then selecting the area, it shows the topmost row. And then the last entity grid, we'll call it the sub-area, is viewed in an area, it's sticky. So really to note is clicking on the home button, as I said before, lands you back in that area assigned to your CRM user in the personal options. And obviously that's customizable if you wish to do that for every user. Again, really, navigation bar, this example here really is switching entity grids between the lead, opportunity, contacts and so on. And what are the benefits? Well, there's no clicking default. The tile panel rolls down upon rollover of a label. The switching entity lands user into the entity grid view. And like I said before, the selecting the chevron pull-down shows the entity type most recently used records. It makes it a lot faster. Really, really good performance of going through. And again here, you can click on the entity name split button to do one of the things now. You can click on the tile and it opens a sub-area again. If the user was in a record, that would take them back to the grid. If the user is already, for example, on the subpage area, then the page refreshes. And then secondly, if by clicking or hovering on the downward arrow, it opens a relevant MIU for that specific entity if it's available for that user. Again, sticking with the navigation bar here, again, we're going down another level here. The left navigation of the form has been removed, as we said, and instead it's been replicated in the top navigation bar. And you can click on the record name split button to do, I say, one of two things. Clicking on the toggle reloads the same entity record. And in the second level menu, clicking on that tile opens the relevant associated grid for that specific entity. Beg your pardon. So the navigation bar content, or like no, really like a breadcrumb tracking the navigation tree, it doesn't change. When you click on an associated grid, you will still see the parent records header. Hence the context is maintained, which is really important. So really what the benefit for this is, clicking on the tile, it opens up the related grid, which the user is interested in. Remember a few moments ago talking about the different colours, and some people might wonder, well, what are those different colours for? You know, why aren't they all red or green or yellow? Again, customizable. There's four types. You've got the core entities, you've got the non-core entities, activities and custom entities. You can see here the non-core are in grey, the activities are in red. Left hand side there you can see like phone call and tasks, appointments and the emails. And then custom entities, well, they're in green. This example here, opportunity. And as I said, like campaign response and competitor, they will be in grey. So they're a different colour scheme that you have noticed when you click on that create button and the top right hand corner there, for example, they're the colour schemes for it. Well, that's the end of today's short brief introduction into kind of the site flattening and the new user interface in CRM 2013. Hope it's been a nice quick insight into you, into the new product and comparing it to CRM 2011. And look forward to listening to the next presentation on the new features of Microsoft Dynamics CRM 2013. Thank you.